Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day. Don't forget, grab your smartphone and download the Lava Matra app and stay in touch. Guru Maharaj's message is your advantage.
Shri Chaitanya Ishvara Hari Om Tat Sat. Please read the verse.
So we're reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 1, Chapter 2, Text Number 16. The verse is written on the board. This chapter is titled Divinity and Divine Service. Shushrusho Shagadanasya Vasudeva Katharuchi Shanmaha Sevaya Vipra Punyatita Nishevana Shushrusho Shagadanasya Vasudeva Katharuchi Shanmaha Sevaya Vipra Punyatita Nishevana Shushrusho.
One who is engaged in hearing.
Sadadanasya.
With care and attention.
Vasudeva.
In respect to Vasudeva.
Kata. The message.
Ruchihi.
Affinity.
Chah.
Is made possible. Mahatsevaya.
By service rendered to pure devotees.
Vipraha,
all
twice born.
Punyatirtha,
those who are cleansed
of all vice.
Nishevana,
by
service. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace. Abhicharana Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki. Translation. O twice born sages, by serving those devotees who are completely free from all vice, great service is done. By such service, one gains affinity for hearing the message of Vasudeva. Purport. The conditioned life of a living being is caused by his revolting against the Lord. There are men called Deva, or godly living beings, and there are men called Asuras, or demons, who are against the authority of the Supreme Lord. In the Bhagavad Gita, chapter 16, a vivid description of the Asuras is given, in which it is said that the Asuras are put into lower and lower states of ignorance, life after life, and so sink into the lower animal forms and have no information of the absolute truth, the personality of God. These asuras are gradually rectified to God consciousness by the mercy of the Lord's liberated servitors in different countries according to the Supreme Will. Such devotees of God are very confidential associates of the Lord, and when they come to save human society from the dangers of godlessness, they are known as the powerful incarnations of the Lord. As sons of the Lord, as servants of the Lord, or as associates of the Lord. But none of them falsely claim to be God themselves. This is a blasphemy declared by the Asuras. And the demonic followers of such Asuras also accept pretenders as God or His incarnation. In the revealed scriptures, there is definite information of the incarnation of God. No one should be accepted as God or an incarnation of God unless he is confirmed by the revealed scriptures. The servants of God are to be respected as God by the devotees who actually want to go back to Godhead. Such servants of God are called Mahatmas or Tirthas, and they preach according to particular time and place. The servants of God urge people to become devotees of the Lord. They never tolerate being called God. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was God Himself according to the indication of the Hindu scriptures. When He played the part of a devotee, people who knew Him to be God addressed Him as God, but He used to block His ears with His hands and chant the name of Lord Vishnu. He strongly protested against being called God, although undoubtedly He was God Himself. The Lord behaves so to warn us against unscrupulous men who take pleasure in being addressed as God. The servants of God come to propagate God consciousness, and intelligent people should cooperate with them in every respect. By serving the servant of God, one can please God more than by directly serving the Lord. The Lord is more pleased when He sees that His servants are properly respected, because such servants risk everything for the service of the Lord and so are very dear to the Lord. The Lord declares in the Bhagavad Gita, that 1869, that no one is dearer to Him than one who risks everything to preach His glory. By serving the servants of the Lord, one gradually gets the quality of such servants, and thus one becomes qualified to hear the glories of God. The eagerness to hear about God is the first qualification of a devotee eligible for entering the kingdom of God. I repeat this last sentence. The eagerness to hear about God is the first qualification of a devotee eligible for entering the kingdom of God. Oh, that's sad.
Translation.
O twice born sages, by serving those devotees who are completely free from all vice, great service is done. By such service, one gains affinity for hearing the messages of Vasudeva.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Krishna Krishna.
Krishna Krishna.
Hare Hare.
Hare Hare.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Rama Rama.
Rama Rama.
Hare Hare.
Hare Hare.
Srimad Bhagavatam Gandharaj Ki
Jai.
This verse tells us that by serving the great soul, we are able to develop an affinity to hearing the message of Vasudeva. translation given from the word Rushi. That Rushi literally means taste. That we have a taste for hearing about the message of Vasudeva or Krishna, simply by serving his devotee. The devotee is described as a servant of the Lord, says they're a son of God, and associate of the Lord, a son of a prophet, but he never claims to be the Lord himself. So Lord Chaitanya, although he was the Lord, he came as a devotee. The Lord in the role as a devotee. Therefore, he didn't accept anyone to call him as the Lord. There were two exceptions. One, he was in the mood of Krishna. But there was just some very special day. Otherwise, he'd come to us here and say, this though, what you're saying, I'm not the Lord, I'm just a devotee. He was teaching by his example how we should act, how we should deal. I heard that the Swami Narayana, when he went through the tour in Ahmedabad, they told us that in his writings, he always glorifies Krishna. So that was nice to hear. But then we heard that some of his disciples called him as Krishna himself, and he was weak to reject this. So therefore, some of his followers, the Swami Narayana sect, they think that he is directly Narayana or Krishna. So like this, there's no excuse for falling prey. Even if the followers say, oh, we think for me you're Krishna, we don't accept. Lord Chaitanya didn't accept. We don't accept. Prabhupada didn't accept. We say, no. I'm a servant of the Lord. When Narada Muni appeared to Adula Maharaj, Adula Maharaj asked, are you Narayan? Are you the personality of Godhead? And Narada Muni replied, no. I can lead you to Narayan, but I am not Narayan. And she saw, this is the role of a guru, not to assert that he is Krishna, but rather to lead the fallen souls back to home, back to Krishna. So, I was somewhere in Rajamundry, and there next to the temple, there's one a copy of the text. So, husband and wife, elderly couple. So the devotee challenged him that it says, copy will appear some 420,000 years after, or 20,000, at the end of Kali Yuga. which is over 4,000 years. So he didn't know what to say. He said, well, I'm the one who shows Kali. And then he was being so much embarrassed by the devotees and challenging him publicly that you're not Kali. Kali doesn't appear for hundreds of thousands of years. Then he said, I am now Allah Bhagavan. I changed my title. I don't mean to call it, but I am Bhagavan. And I'm Allah Bhagavan. So you can get a special blessing to me. You take 5 lakhs of rupees. I'll give you a special blessing and drink it. And for 2 days you're in sin. And this way, he gives a special blessing. I mean, all of you are stupid enough to pay 5 lakhs of rupees. He'll give you a drink that makes you all highly intoxicated. He's probably arrested and hung here in Malaysia for drugs. But he gives some mix. The Saudis will still accept him as the Bhagavan. And they pay tens of thousands of lakhs of rupees in order to get his blessings. So all kinds of this in India, you see, Bhagavan, he says, Son of Rami, Yuge Yuge, I come in every yuga. But they don't come in every yuga, they're coming every millennium, every year, every hour, every 10 minutes. So these are not the real Bhagavan. The Kali Yuga, the number of the demons is so great that many are claiming to be Bhagavan. Bhakti Vinod Thakur, he had to deal with the Bhagavan. It's a Thalbubala who was claiming to be a Bhagavan. There was some other recently, Asan Baba in Arisha, who claimed the avatar of Jagannath. So you close the door, when you open it, then they all hug Jagannath Prasad. Even Jagannath Prasad is rarely on time, but his Prasad is always be on time. So, people thought, oh, he's Jagannath, he's Bhagavan. But he had a tunnel, and they were smoking on the ground. They were cooking the food, yeah, some distance away, and they were bringing it by tunnel and putting it in front of him. So, the police raided this person because he was also dancing with others' wives. Since he said he was Krishna, so he started to do Rasa Lila with his wives. So the husbands were complaining. This Bhagavan is cheating. So they raided and they found that there was a trap door, and underneath the ground there was a tunnel. And there was a group of people who were cooking. So he had a whole thing set up to cheat the people. So this, he was exposed. Similarly, in Bengal, there was another one. He claimed to be the 15th generation of Lord Chaitanya. So he was, smoking on the dais. And he let people come and touch his feet. So they said when they touched his feet, they felt a deathly chill. Taking all their karma or something. So may be up a deathly chill. And they thought this is like some blessing. So I should not. And suddenly he died. So they kept his body on the ice slab. So then the neighbor said, you should take the body and bury it. He's dead. So no, no, he's not dead. He's a nearly old salami. So the way I give him an ice, but his salami is very hot. They cool him down. So then finally, they complained to the police that this guy, he's dead, they're not disclosing, according to the law, they have to disclose of the body within a certain time, 24 hours or whatever. They're not doing that. So the police raided and they found a lookalike. Oh, it's like, this growing in there. So it'd be the same length, you know, lookalike. They're gonna switch the body to a lookalike. They say, oh, he's come back from here and called the body. There he is. And so in the meantime, they're selling the lockets half price. They want to get rid of their huge stock. So they want to get rid of their stock of lockets. And here it explodes that these, this was their trick. So they give you a hard time all so many. These are the so-called Vishnu, Chaitanya, Krishna avatar. Then there's Kali avatar, Hanuman avatar, there's Durga avatar, there's so many avatars. So-called avatars. But these are not the real thing. The real thing is three tests. They should mention in the Shastra. They should match up with what's said in the Shastra. And they should do some activity which an ordinary soul cannot do. These are the three qualities. So, Kalki at least is mentioned in the scripture. But he is supposed to come at the end of the Yuga after 400,000 years. So he doesn't match up. Apart from that, he doesn't do anything special. So the other so-called avatars, they don't want to achieve, they don't qualify in any of them. I mean, they don't even mention the scripture. So right there it stops. But what to think of being according to the scripture and doing some miracle. There's some Baba in South India, he does a little magic trick. So we were told by the Sikkar magician, Sikkar Junior, that this Baba actually was in the same magic school as he was. And so he learned some of the magic. By the way, we have Maharshan. He wants to perform some magic for you, especially for the kids. But he doesn't claim to be Bhagavan. Now, this Baba claims to be Bhagavan because he wears long sleeves and he pulls out washes and rings and things. So people think he must be Bhagavan because he has that magic. So the Sikkar Guru told us, I'm a magician, and I tell people I'm a magician. These are tricks we learn as a magician. I don't claim to be Bhagavan. So, why did this Baba claim to be Bhagavan? So I asked, I wanted to see him. But when he gave me my name as a Sikkar, he said, the magician, I don't see him. So I was curious, why he doesn't want to see me? So then he gave it some other name later, came, and then he could see the Baba. So then he asked the Baba, I saw you, you were in the same magic school as me. Why do you think the Baba? And he said, I don't harm anyone. I'm doing some charitable work. I own the hospital, that would work. So I bother my mind to serve not what I got going. People like to believe they go on, so let them believe that. They give me donations, I use it for charitable work. I'm not hurting anybody. This is what this Sirkar musician told us. His discussion with the Lola. You can imagine which Lola I'm talking about, from South India. Anyway, yeah, so later, the Lola, one of his followers, said that this Sirkar came to see him. He was turned into a goat, and they showed a picture of a goat. That was too much. Then he said, I'm not turning to a goat. I'm still here. And this Balar is a cheater. But nobody wants to listen. They're all happy. Okay, Balar, bless your blessing. Because he got thousands of followers around the world, so okay, he's rich. So, like this. This thing can run on anything. We want to develop the affinity to listen to the real story of Vasudeva, not all these false imitation, all the so-called avatars. We want to realize, we want to hear the real message of Krishna. Krishna is really the personality of Godhead. I was at the Bhaktivedanta Hospital, and they have a spiritual care department. That department is taking care of the different patients who come there to the hospital. Now, most of the patients, they don't know who Bhaktivedanta is. They don't know this hospital. They think that Bhaktivedanta is some saint, some sadhu. So they named this hospital after him. Like so many hospitals in India are named after this Baba or that, so on. So, but actually, it's run by our devotees mainly, and there's a few doctors who are not devotees, but large part, and 60% of the devotee nurses are devotees, 60 or 50. So, one of the patients was in the ICU. He was from Delhi. So he had different magazines of different groups. And they said, oh, you're interested in the spiritual life. He said, yes, but I have a doubt. My doubt is, who is actually God? Every group says their founder is God. The Brahma Kumari said, Prasadati, this Saiva Roots, the Saiva Dharma. And this is so many, every group is saying their founder is the God. And then the sisters from the Christian here. You know, we have the same doubt by read in the Bhagavad Gita. The Krishna says, he's God. Really? It says in the Bhagavad Gita. Yes. That's what I always wanted to know. Who is really God? Oh, this is good news. How did someone has told me who God is? Oh, I'm so happy. Can you show me that in the Bhagavad Gita? They show the Hamsara Rasha Prabhupada. They show the different parts where Krishna admits that he is the personality of Godhead, the universal form, and so on. So then he started to chant, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So in this way, they make about 30 devotees, 25 to 30 every month, who just come as the patients of patronage. The Hindus, the Muslims, the Arahants, according to their Shastra, they tell the Muslims to chant Tasbih. I don't want much to maintain by Allah, Muhammad, Allah, or something. They tell the Christians to chant Rosary, and they chant, tell the Hindus to chant Hare Krishna. Some like that, they need a minister to have me like, but suddenly one Christian and he said, my doctor is a Hindu. So I want both a Christian and a Hindu rights when I die. So they also have, like, for those who are terminally ill, they give a special care that when they die, they'll sprinkle the Ganges water, they'll give a garland to the deity. So they'll do different things according to our lady rights, Vaishnava custom. I think it's the only hospital. I was in the Hindu hospital, and I was in the ICCU, the, what they call the critical care. The ICU, this is the worst, is the ICCU, the critical care unit. So I was all night long, all day long, they keep you awake. Because you're under constant observation, your blood pressure, your everything. I was overhearing this doctor talking by telephone to the police. Come on, you're a dead body here. You're a dead body. You're the one who says 24 hour service. We want to take the dead body out of here. Quick, you come here, give us a certificate, and let us remove this body. Other patients will see, they'll get demoralized. So, wow. Dead body. Get rid of it. Get rid of it. Kill it. Yeah, it's just a terrible. Tell it. Get rid of it. That's not how they treat in the Bhakti Vedanta hospital. The body of the self-patient dying. It's a given. I mean, you think hospital means you're all survive. It's not like that. Some do die. They have some terminal disease like cancer or something. In the Bhakti Vedanta hospital, they do take final rites. If they are Hindus or Christians or Muslims, then according to they do whatever they ask for. As well as a Christian, they bring the padre and they do the rites. If they're a Muslim, they bring the mullah, the imam, and he does the rites. They don't mind. That way it's truly universal. And some, they say, do both the rights. We want both of the rights. So they do both. They first do the Vaisha, they should know what Ganges, the water, and then they put the Imam or the Christian priest come and do their whatever they want to do. So, it's a I think every hospital should have this kind of spiritual care department. And the Vishwarup Das, he's the person who's in charge of that department. He says he's willing to, you know, give support, give training to anyone who wants to do that kind of department. So I got one hospital in Coimbatore, the KG hospital, so I don't know, here in Malaysia. What's the harm? If, I mean, we're not, it's like, it's not converting anyone. If they're Muslim, they do Muslim rites. They bring in the Imam. They do whichever right just the people want. So that's, one of the very special cares that they offer. So, but most of the people in that environment, a lot of the religious and some of the people They do one thing, Hindu rites. And so we do the Vaishnava rite of drinking the Ganges water and reading the Srimad Bhagavatam. There was one lady, she was an atheist. So they asked her, her father had 4th stage of cancer in lungs, which means there's no hope by modern medicine. So they asked her if she would read the Bhagavad Gita for her father. They were reading, but she said, how much I got to pay? She thought all religions were just after money. He said, no, no, you don't have to pay anything. He said, we don't mind doing it, but we have to care for so many hundreds of patients. And we don't have the time to just spend it with your father. If you read sometimes, but if you read, it's better. We don't charge. You can have the Bhagavad Gita. You can leave it to your father. You don't charge. No, it's a free service. Wow. I thought all religions are just after money. That's why I don't believe in any religion. No, no, we're not after money. We want to help your father to achieve his eternal life. So she started reading the Bhagavad Gita to her father. And she realized that the Krishna consciousness was a different. So later, they actually brought this lady to see me when I was in the hospital as a patient. And they said, she said that she chants 8 to 16 rounds. She now believes in Krishna. She brings her friends to the hospital. And she sponsors a weekly feed sometimes. She was a changed person. You see, so we can make a difference. Your Navana Puja, by the way, I wasn't able to see. I hope I get a CD of the Navana. But I inaugurated it this year, but I don't know what the results were. But your Navana today, yesterday rather, Paranamala came from he said, in Prague, now we got inspired by the Palampur congregation, so he done the Dhamma program. And some thousands of houses, tens of thousands of people offered that. And now they're finding that if they saw many people, they didn't know that there was a ISKCON center in the city. They didn't know that that we did this kind of program. And so they said, oh, it really helps our teaching. So this congregation is inspiring people all over the world. Just like I'm telling you about the Bhaktivedanta Hospital, because it's a rare hospital. I tell other places about the Kualampur congregation, because you are a rare congregation. All of you are active, you're preachers, you're serious devotees. See, a lot of our congregations are not so much into it, but you're showing the way. So keep it up, and I'm sure by serving the devotees who come here, you'll all attain affinity for hearing the message of Vasudeva, as you heard the name of the verse. And you're inspiring people all over the world. Unfortunately, only one of the other, Uttama Chaitanya Das, he was a real, initiative to spread the message of the congregational development throughout Southeast Asia. Throughout India, he went to Mauritius and to South Africa. Unfortunately for us, fortunately for him, he was taken back to Godhead. And we lost his association. So now you should carry on with his, when he left his legacy, to spread the Krishna consciousness, to spread the Navata, to spread these different programs and the Dhammadhara Puja. I'm getting excited. Maybe I'm thinking too fast. I'm sorry. Anyway, I just wanted to tell you this, that you make a difference because you are showing how to be active in Krishna consciousness as vihasas, as students. You know, we have a few brahmacharis, but I know most of you are grihasthas and are on the path to being a grihastha. So this is a very good example. And I want to thank you all very much. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.
I came to this hall some years ago. I remember that we had some program then. I wasn't sick of it. We came and I spoke here. And here I am again. So by your prayers, by the best wishes of the devotees around the world, by Rasnali and Bhagavatishma and Bhaktishma and Sharasha, the GBCs, I'm still here. But I see that we have such a wonderful devotees here in Malaysia and in India, and I want to spend more time here. Once I have recovered. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.